impact the environment too bad. This is all dwarf pine trees of Tormented Valley. Little clap there, help me synchronize the audio from the recorder. Let's see if I can remember north to Alaska. That was a neat song, Johnny Horton, covered by Paul. That was an attempt anyway. You know, hey, when you're about 64, your memory starts to go. Every now and then I sharpen mine, I use a memory board. Got it from the hardware store. Hope the White Sox don't lay some eggs under my skin here. Sam left Seattle in the year of 91 with George Pratt, his partner. Oh, no, year 92. With George Pratt, his partner, and brother Billy, too. They cross the Yukon River, find the bonanza gold. Just below that old white mountain, just a little southeast of Nome. Where the river is winding, big nuggets they're finding. North to Alaska, we're going north, the rush is on. Of course, here in Tormented Valley, this is Canada. Matter of fact, the border was disputed. Canada had Great Britain behind her, which had just won the War of 1812 in the same century, but that's... Remember, 1814, we took a little trip along Colonel Jackson down the mighty Mississippi. Well, they lost that war, and Dolly Madison had to rescue the Constitution from Washington, D.C., so on and so forth. So it was a disputed territory. The United States thought this would be Alaska. Aliskia. The Russians were too vague. They tried to ask the Tlingit natives, you know, of the time, and said, do you remember anything about the Russians? Oh, them, they said. Yeah, they came here. They could not fish. They could not hunt. We killed them. And they figured they were doing them a favor. Anyway. Now, what are you? That's not a White Sox, anyway. Yeah, see what the miners came up through here and up the White Pass. This is the some of the White Pass just over there. They got stuck up here, had to winter. 40 below, 20 feet of snow minimum. These trees here are bonsai trees growing on a little soil and rock underneath. They're covered with 20 feet of snow in the wintertime. Well, they say that they just about all starved to death. The only ones that survived were the ones that ate the others. Until Molly Wall started a feeding station up there. But then the Canadians said, okay, the border is going to be the summit of the pass. And they mounted a couple of machine guns up there and said, okay, you boys, you can't come here unless you've got a year's worth of provender. A year's worth of supplies. And they probably saved millions of, or thousands, hundred thousands of lives. Along with Soapy Smith, Smith and his gang used to rob the miners and then pay their passage back to Seattle. Some of us say, now, Soapy, you know that wasn't nice thing to do with that poor man. Soapy said, hell, I saved his life. He would have died up there in Tormented Valley. Sam looked to George. Did I get that right? No. George looked to Sam with his gold in his hand. He said, Sam, you're looking at a lonely, lonely man. I'd trade all the gold that's buried in this land for one small bit of gold on my little sweet Jenny's hand. 'Cause a man needs a woman to love him all the time. Remember, Sam, a true love is so hard to find. I'd trade all this gold that's buried in this land for a little ring of gold on my dear sweet Jenny's hand. Where the river is winding, big nuggets they're finding. North to Alaska, we're going north, the rush is on. I said north to Alaska, we're going north, the rush is on. And there's something about Sam mushing his huskies, you know what? That's why they used to cook with mushrooms in their stew, because that way the huskies would have mushroom. I guess they were gourmet muskies. muskies. That's anyway. I said no to Alaska, we're going north, the rush is on.